Hi, my name is Roger. In this video, we will take care of our last push button, subtracting 1/1000 of a second. Let me show you the code behind it. Of course, you already know that stuff, so you've seen it. There we go. Here we have the first function, milsec 1000, subtract from start. We have to do things again a little bit different when you subtract something. So we're going to replace all the commas, all the commas with a double point, and we're going to split at the double point. You've seen this before, so it can't be a big surprise. These are the variables. All of the variables are integers. Element nil is hours, element one is minutes, element two is seconds. This here is write one is a 1/1000 of a second. MS left is from the 1/1000 of a second, the one on the left, and this one is MS mid is the one in the middle. So which one are we working on? Well, very easy. Let me do it like this. Comment. We are working on the last one. On this one. Let me do it like this for you. MS left is this one. MS mid is this one. And MS is this one. So now you know what these are all, how you can populate all that stuff. I don't have to explain that anymore. We have to check all of them. We have to check all of these. If they are nil, well, then we have to write a nil, put it in new time, and put it in the list box. It's all the same as before. So here we have else if MS is greater than nil, then, well, then we can subtract something from it, and we're going to write it back into new time, and new time we're going to add right there. Else, well, else one of these must have something, at least a one. So else we're going to do this, MS greater than nil, we're going to subtract one string MS, two from the left, and we're going to put that in new time over here, so our list box gets populated. Else if MS is nil, then we're going to do this. We're going to put in 9, 2 from the left of element 3, then we have new time. We're going to write new time into the list box, and we're going to do this function here. We're going to subtract 1/100 of a second from our start time. So we're going to subtract 1 from this one. That's basically what we do. So that's it for this one. Of course, you know by now that the end time is the same thing. That's the name of the array. This here is the column number. And here we have a different function name because we are dealing with the end time of that particular subtitle. So you have to call milsec 100 subtract from the end time, or whatever you have called it. If you want both of them together in one function, copy and paste the start time, paste it in, and you are good to go. So that's it for our subtitle editor. It's been quite a lot. And if you have questions, let me know, then I can answer or make a video for you about it so you can understand it a little bit better.